Hello, welcome to the Blessman Report and our new podcast, Meat Not Milk, and our relationship segment, Agape. And today we are talking about top five reasons God does not care about your type. So we're just gonna start really easy, just making the distinction between type, preferences, and standards. So standards are what God likes, and then your preferences and your type are what you like. So standards are non-negotiables. You have to have those. You have to be with someone who is a Christian and is keeping the Ten Commandments. But everything else in between is up to you. And so those are preferences versus like the standards of God. So number five, physical attraction is shallow and immature. So your type and what you're attracted to is just up to legitimately your culture and your surroundings. And you cannot control like your genetics. So evidence that you have the Holy Spirit is in Galatians 5. It is all personality traits. And so what does that come down to? That's goodness, kindness, meekness, self-control, gentleness, love, joy, peace. Everything that does not have to do with physical character traits. Versus when you have a type, it doesn't seem like types are ever character. They're always something to do with how you look, and oftentimes just things that don't really add to a good spouse or a good dating partner, but just things that are superfluous and really don't matter. So why is character and internal traits so harped on while physical traits are so downplayed in the Bible? And you see this in 1 Samuel 16:7, and it says that do not look at his appearance or his physical stature, because I refuse him. For the Lord does not see as man sees. For man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. So it's just like really shallow stuff. And even I think it's really interesting that God takes the time in scriptures to point out Jesus' physical traits, and it says that he is unbecoming. So basically, Jesus was like a basic looking dude. And he points this out in scriptures so that we know that what was attracting people to Jesus was the glory of God, not that he was like extra handsome or anything. So number five, yo, God doesn't care about your type because it's being shallow and pretty immature. All right, so number four, it is limiting. So just to be honest, we legitimately track record. Our track record for being single is not the best, right? And so since it is not the best, we may not know what is best for us. We have people that we thought were it, and they weren't it. And we are wrong when we went off of our own type. So what if we're wrong again and don't know what's best for us because we are single? And when I say this, it's like insanity. The definition is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. So why do we think we can date the same type of person if we're still single and somehow have different results? Maybe God knows better than us. So I just have two quick examples when it comes to women and also to men. So a really easy one for women, they have like a height criteria. Hey, I just want to date someone over 6 foot and above, but that is pretty limiting. So just so you know that the numbers, in the United States alone, only 15% of men are 6 foot and over. So if you were to transfer that over to race, you would have to get rid of the white Caucasian population and the black population just so you have the same numbers that you're throwing away in your restrictor of height, being 6 foot, which is such an arbitrary trait because no one can control their genetics and their height, all right? And again, just for men and just like the women that I have dated, with my type have always been extroverted women that are like fuller in figure, right? So how childish and limiting is it for me to tell God, like, hey God, I don't date quiet women and I don't date skinny women or even a combination of the two. So maybe my wife is in that pool that I'm denying, right? So having a type is limiting because you're actually missing out on some pretty quality people that you may enjoy. So God doesn't care about your type because it's pretty limiting and you're not letting his sovereignty of knowing best and better than us coming to play. So number three, attraction changes and so does your type. And that's why God doesn't care about your type, because there's so many regular factors like age, culture, and your surroundings, right? So what you're attracted to at 10 years old is not what you're attracted to at 20, at 30, at 40 in your singleness. So when it comes to just primal physiology, men are pretty basic and their initial attraction is physical traits, but they do have the capacity to be attracted to anyone. But in women, their primal attraction comes from emotions, feeling, in relation to proximity. So what that means is that the more time that you spend with someone just as a woman, they will become more physically attracted to you. So you'll actually like anybody, so anybody could be your type. So if you are basically cutting people off because they are not your type, you're not allowing the oxytocin in the brain. So the oxytocin is the connection drug in your physiology that is supposed to bring people together. And so if you don't spend enough time because you're like, nope, he is not my type, you don't get any of the attributes in physiology, so he can become more attracted to you. So I mean, to you. So you can become attracted to him just because he has a great personality, because he is funny, because he is intelligent, whatever other cool, he has good people skills, he's confident, anything else that is a better factor in attraction than actually just physical looks, height, anything else that just is shallow. So God doesn't care about your type because your type changes. And yo, we have to be less shallow, all right? So number two, why God does not care about your type, God is not obligated to obey us. So there's just this misconception that God answers to us, which is the complete opposite, is that we answer to God. And this is people being delusional, and somehow the Bible promises that everyone is getting married, which it does not promise. So people believe that they are entitled to a spouse because everyone's getting married, and so you have a lot of choice because God's destined to give you a spouse. So they say, I don't know about everybody else, but I know what God has promised me to verify. It's just vanity and sometimes even lust. But in reality, it's the complete opposite. And this is the verse that they use to justify their beliefs. And it's Psalms 37:4. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. But that verse does not say that God gives you whatever you want and desire. That verse says that if you delight in the Lord, God will give you the desires, right? He will give you what you want, not the things that your desires want, but you will begin to desire things that he wants you to desire. So God is not a genie or a matchmaker where we could treat people like Build-A-Bear. And our lives are not like this movie where we are the main characters and people are just things and objects to be supporting cast to our lives. But Jesus is the guy. Jesus is the main character, and we are all the supporting cast to him. So we also see this verified in scriptures with James 4:3. Ye ask and receive not, because you ask amiss, that you may consume it upon your own lust. So right there, God says like, hey, I'm not giving you what you ask for because you're asking out of lust. You're asking out of your own desires and not my desire and my will, being sovereign and having the authority to do as I will. But you're doing it out of what you want, what you desire. And the Bible says like, yo, the heart is deceitfully wicked. What person can know it? It's like, yo, you don't really know your own heart. You don't know your own self, character, or your desires. And the Bible also says like, hey, do not deceive yourself. So a lot of times, I think we get heartbroken or that verse in the Bible that says, hope deferred makes the heart sick. We make expectations on God that he never promises, but we put God's name on there and say, God destined this for me. He didn't destine anything at all. And so we just have to be really sober-minded of like, hey, is this coming from just from me or is this coming from God and his will? All right. And then number one reason God does not care about your type is familiar spirits. So what if your type is destructive? What if what you're attracted to is dysfunction and you're not attracted to holiness and it's actually pretty boring to you? What if you're not attracted to godliness but you're attracted to sin, to carnality? What if you're being led by lust and justifying it by calling it your type? So in reality, we have to be really sober minded of like, yo, what if I don't know best and I keep dating the same person and different people? And so what you have is this thing called familiar spirits. Not saying like lust can't be a spirit, I'm not really sure how the Bible outlines it, but toxicity in yourself can definitely be attractive in someone else. So something broken, immature, something hurting or damaged in you, you may see that reflection in someone else and that may be attractive to you, and that's your type. And so there's a lot of things just in the subconscious that even if we're not going spiritually and we're just going physiology and psychology wise, you might be finding in other people, and that is your type. And so if we were going just spiritual, you may have a demonic spirit in someone else that is speaking to something carnal, sinful, unholy, demonic in you. And you see this with like drunkenness, right? It just seems that people who have an appetite for sin, for the flesh, for a carnal living, congregate towards one another. So that is a bad type to have. So we can't believe that what we want and what we attract is healthy or is beneficial towards us. So just know you attract what you are, not what you want. So you may want to have like stable, functional relationship, but what you're attracted to is dysfunction. And so if you're attracted to two different things, that your actions and your wants and your behaviors are in conflict with one another, then it may not be in your best interest to continually go after what you want and desire. All right, so yo, I'm open-minded. Let me hear from you in the comment section below. Are you open to dating outside of your type and your preferences? Or are you like, no, Winston, you're wrong. The Bible definitely supports having a type. And yo, I don't want to go off of feelings, or God does not withhold any good or perfect thing. I want like scriptures in context of like, yeah, the Bible actually supports what I'm saying, and not like feelings of the flesh or us deceiving ourselves, right? All right, so thank you for watching the Blessing Report with our Meat Not Milk podcast. Make sure to leave a rating, a comment, like the video, share the video, and remember, our podcasts are on all platforms like iTunes, Spotify, and all your other areas. And remember to tune in next week for our next Agape segment when it comes to our Relationship Thursdays, where we are talking about the top 10 lies that the church tells single Christians. So make sure to come back, and I'll see you next Thursday. Thank you for watching, rating, subscribing to our YouTube channel, and subscribing to our podcast. Thanks for watching.